let's rise up for the reading of God's word. Proverbs chapter 31 from verse 10. I'm going to read verse 10 in King James Version. I'm going to switch to NIV and I'll wrap it up in NIV. Verse 10 said, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. Who can find? That means it's not easy to find. You can find a woman, but a virtuous one is difficult. NIV said, a wife. That means virtuous women are quick to be made wives. A wife of what? Noble character. So you may be a wife, but are you of noble character? Are you a wife with an attitude? Or with a noble attitude? A wife of noble character, who can find? She is worth far more than rubies. Her husband has full confidence in her, and her husband lacks nothing of value. That is to say, the entrance of that woman in the life of a man downloads value. She brings him good, not harm, all the days of her life. She is clothed, verse 25, with strength and dignity. She can laugh at the days to come. She speaks with wisdom, and faithful instruction is on her tongue. She watches over the affairs of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children arise and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. Verse 29. Many women do noble things. I thought we mentioned noble at the beginning. But you surpass them all. Tonight, I pray for every woman in this ministry. When noble women are mentioned, you shall surpass them all. I don't like the way you are saying amen. I said when noble women are mentioned on the face of the earth, in the name of Jesus, you shall surpass them all. In the name of Jesus, you shall surpass them all. Women, better say amen for yourself. Charm is deceptive, and beauty is fleeting. Mary Kay can fade. Sephora can disappear. But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Verse 31, honor her for all that her hands have done, and let her works bring her praise at the city gate. Lift your right hand up, Lord. Identify 150 to 200 women under the sound of my voice. Raise them as new biblical standard women that will change this generation forever. We give you praise and we give you glory. Anoint your word and bless this house with your word. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. If you are a lady in the house, I want you to tell any other person around you, tell them, I am a virtuous woman. I am a virtuous woman. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. All over this place. In the name of Jesus, I am a virtuous woman. If you know that there is a virtuous woman in your life, I want you to clap your hands and give God praise. Sit down. God bless you. Sit down. You know, in the place where we read, it's a popular part of the scripture. Everybody talked about the Proverbs 31 woman. Proverbs 31 woman. It's great. But I discovered there are some things that made this woman described by the Lord stand out. And this leads me to the topic that I'm going to share with you, the mother or the woman that God uses. I discovered that women play a very good role, a wonderful role in creation. Somebody say, Pastor, how do you know that? Because they are God's extension of creation in procreation. Where God stops, that's where women continue. When God saw man, even though he made man on day six, God looked at man and discovered the only way to upgrade man. No other person was upgraded in creation apart from man. God formed woman. So, mothers, you must understand you are God's upgrade for humanity. May nobody make you a downgrade. If you are a lady in this, I'll tell your neighbor, I'm not a downgrade. Come on, tell them, take it with power. I'm not a downgrade. I'm a divine upgrade. Come on, tell them, I'm not a downgrade. I'm a divine upgrade. Yes. God's idea of women in the scripture is what we call virtuous women. Women with virtue that carry power. And I'm not talking about power as in physical power. There's a kind of power you carry, that power that is not even spoken. Power that does not make noise, but you make influence. You carry significance. You have relevance. From today, may God make you a relevant woman. Amen. Ladies, make sure your amen, as the word is declared, make sure your amen is greater than your neighbor so that God can find you first. Amen. The Bible says, a virtuous woman who can find. That means it's not common. God is trying to raise uncommon mothers. Common mothers are plenty. Uncommon are very rare. And the Bible places and says their price is far above rubies. NIV said a wife of noble character. So God is specifically speaking to mother that there is a character that every mother must have. And it must be a noble one. It's important that we don't allow, and you know, women can have some, you know, every woman is unique in their own way. They're all blessed in their own way. You know, if a woman tells you, I will show you, start running. If you're a married man, there's a way your wife will look at you. You know you're in trouble. There's a way my wife will look at me. I get the message. I just begin to pack my stuff. Yeah, women are, but God wants us to be women of noble character. Can God look at you and say you are a woman of noble character? Can God look at you and say, you know what? Amongst all the women I have in San Antonio, this one is different. My prayer is that God will find such women in better covenant. And the Bible says that when you are a woman of noble character, your value cannot be quantified in monetary terms. Yes. And the Bible says her husband has full confidence in her. Men, you know what I'm talking about. You know there are some things that your wife can do if she looks like a superwoman. You must understand your role in your home and continue to add that value and bring that relevance. I know that God assigned you to that home for a purpose. You are not in that home by mistake. You are not in the life of that man by mistake. You are not the mother of those beautiful children by error. You were divinely orchestrated by God. Do you know that the destinies of great children came out of you? In fact, as I was mentioned on this topic, the Lord told me, every woman have two wombs. I said, Lord, really? He said, yes. They have a physical womb to nurture the babies. And they have a spiritual womb to nurture destinies. Every great man, except Adam, was born by a woman. Even Jesus. Every every great man. I don't know whether you call Adam great, but he is. But every great man after Adam was born by a woman. Even Jesus Christ of Nazareth was born by a woman. So understand that what comes out of you, God did not just wake up and made you. God taught very well. Put a man under general anesthesia. Took out a rib. Made you. That you came out fantastic with a womb to carry another being. So you are not just ordinary. Tell your neighbor, I'm not ordinary. So you must understand that you are a partner with God to making sure that creation does not go into crisis. You are a solution carrier. You are destiny changer. You are a world changer. You are God's vessel in this end time. May God use you mightily in Jesus' name. Yes. So as you understand that in your home is the place where God has placed you to start making these changes, to start making this impact. I pray that God will find you faithful in Jesus' name. The Bible says in your home, that virtuous woman brings good to the man in her life. So every man in your life, whether it's a brother, whether it's a husband, whether it's a son, you are supposed to bring good to them as a woman. Because God has given you the capacity to bring good. You are supposed to bring good to them all the days of your life. God has given you the ability to clothe yourself with strength and dignity. And you will laugh in days to come. I see somebody, God, giving you laughter in Jesus' name. God has also given you the grace to speak with wisdom. You know, women have their way with words. That you be careful the words that come out of your mouth, because death and life is what? Is in the power of the tongue. So the words you speak, whatever you speak about your husband is what he becomes. You said this man is a foolish man. He becomes foolish. Oh, it's true. You say my husband, think about it. Think. Who was the person that said Nabal was a fool? It was Abigail. It's what your wife calls you that you truly are. If a woman says my husband is a Christian, believe her. If they say this man is a Christian, and you look at the wife's reaction, the wife said, we thank God. Your wife know whether you pray or not. Your wife know whether you read the Bible or not. If you as a man, you are preaching on the stage and your wife is saying, just talk, let's go. No, your ministry is in trouble. May God bless the women in Jesus' name. But I'm saying it that women, God has given you the grace to speak with wisdom, and I pray that you will speak with wisdom. Faithful instruction. That's why women must understand, if there is a derailing in your life and in your family, God has given you the wisdom and the faithful instruction to set your family away from the course of destruction. Excuse me. If Delilah had the mouth to derail Samson, Samson's mother had the mouth to bring him back to order. Don't see your family going in the wrong direction and you keep your mouth shut. It is fire versus fire. Oh, am I speaking to somebody? Faithful instruction is in your mouth. Ladies, tell your neighbor, faithful instruction is in my mouth. Yes. God also says that virtuous woman that God uses, she maintains the affairs of her household. Nobody will take care of your house for you. Women, you are the chief controlling manager of your house. The man may give you a house, you make it a home. Am I speaking to somebody? Who know? I don't care what the professor tells the child. The mother is the first professor to the child. Anybody agree with me? So understanding your role, mothers, that you are the one that God will use to shape that home. If your home is a loving home, it's your fault. If your home is disorganized, it is your fault. Understanding your role. That's where I'm going this morning. I'm just giving you an introduction. And the Bible says, as you continue to do these things, that your as you continue to build your home, you don't eat the bread of idleness, that your children one day will arise and call you blessed. I pray for every woman in this house, every mother in this house, may God raise your children to call you blessed. But understand, it is what you invest in them that will make them call you blessed tomorrow. Her husband also will rise up and call her and praise her. And the Bible says, many women do noble things, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceptive. We all know that. That's not where I'm going. Beauty is fleeting. Now we're coming to the meat of the matter. But the Bible says, a woman that fears the Lord. Tell your neighbor, a woman that fears the Lord. She shall be what? So that means the moment you stop fearing God, you lose praise. Lack of fear of God will chip off your honor. And the things we talked about, your speech, your attitude, your character, are the things that truly show that you fear God or not. A woman that talks anyhow and gossip, you don't fear God. I'm telling you, if you like, pray and speak Christianese. You don't. Because the Bible says, through multitude of words, sin is not what? Sin is not lacking. So truly a virtuous woman, you count your words. Tell your neighbor, fear God. Now, let's look in the scriptures. What are some of the things and some examples of women in the scripture, for sake of time, that did amazing things that we can look and wonder? In the scripture, I discovered that there were some great mothers who influenced the works of God, that were valuable in the hand of God. People that changed their sphere of influence. Examples of those are Mary, Salome, Mary and Martha, Anna the prophetess. These are wonderful people that God used. Other people that we know in the scripture are Deborah. Deborah was a leader. Hannah was a prayerful woman. Rebecca was a skillful nurturer of destiny. Rebecca was the person that saw that, according to the scripture, when there was trouble in her stomach, she inquired of the Lord. And they said, there are two nations inside of you. Ladies and gentlemen, do you know nations came out of you? Don't treat them like chickens when there are nations. Don't treat them like houseboy. Don't treat them like slaves. If you know that there is a call, you every mother, when you see a child, you know a child who the call of God is upon their life. So when you know that, stop treating that child like you don't understand the significance and the role of that child. Moses' mother knew that this was a goodly child. So against the law of Pharaoh, she was willing to die. Kill me instead of killing this boy. She knew that. So what I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, especially women here under the sound of my voice, you cannot allow things to happen around you without understanding that God puts you as the caretaker of the spiritual destinies of your husband and your children. That's your role. Tell your neighbor that's your role. Oh, tell your neighbor that is your role. Yeah, Rebecca, very skillful. She was the one that knew how to cook a one-year-old lamb and make it taste like bushmeat. The Bible says that Isaac said, I want to eat again from the field. That's like wild meat. If you know what they call it, that's what we call grass cutter, bushmeat. And the Bible says, and Esau went to the farm to hunt the meat to get a blessing. Rebecca was standing right there. Is somebody hear what I'm saying? And Rebecca heard the word and said, don't worry. You go take a one-year-old kid from the backyard. So what Esau was looking for in the field, Rebecca knew where it was in the house. Do you know there are many things your husband is looking for? If only you are wise enough to say, honey, I slept last night. What you are looking for is not there. It is here. Somebody say, Pastor, but what if the woman does not listen? There is a way you will make him listen. How did you get him to propose? Ladies and gentlemen, there's a way you cook a certain meal. The man's spiritual antenna will correct. There's a way you will dress. There's a word you will say. It will get your husband off his feet. Ladies and gentlemen, you need to use what God has given to you to get your home in order. The man did not hear. Eh? He will hear. If a woman wants to make her husband come to church, she can do it. Find out his favorite food. Pamper him and take care of him. Sit next to him. I have a question to ask you. There's a way you do. She will say, what do you want? Say, I want you to come to church with me. He will come. Excuse me. How did Esther was able to catch the attention of the king? Don't tell me you don't got what it takes. If God could put a man to sleep for you to come out, God can do anything to that man. Am I speaking to somebody this morning? Tell your neighbor, God has anointed you. God has anointed you. Yes. Abigail was an intelligent and wise woman. The Shunammite was a wealthy and well-respected person. Anna was a prophetess. Mary was a barrier breaker, a line crosser, a world changer. This gives us the true picture of biblical women that God used. What are the qualities? Number one, women that fear God and make the Lord their priority. If you want God to use you as a woman, you must fear God. Tell your neighbor, fear God. Fear God means to run away from sin. That's exactly what Mary, that was the characteristic of Mary. Mary was a person that feared God. She was a virgin. I'm talking about Mary, the mother of Jesus. Excuse me, do you know what God used Mary to do? Mary made Nazareth a national, international pilgrimage center. When I went to Israel the last time, Reverend, you can attest to it. When you go to Nazareth, you ask yourself truly, what good thing can come out of Nazareth? The place is ordinary, but Mary made it extraordinary. Somebody, something extraordinary is coming out of your house after this service. I'm talking to a woman, I'm talking to a mother. After today's service, when you step into your house, something extraordinary is coming out of your house. Am I talking to somebody this morning? I said, after this service, as you shout the next amen, something extraordinary is coming out of your house. Shout a big amen.
First criteria why the angel picked her was not because she was a virgin, because there were many virgins, but because she was a virgin that feared the Lord. Tell your neighbor, fear the Lord. Yeah. Mary was ordinary, but her fear of God made her extraordinary. What qualified her was because she was able to identify with Jesus Christ. Her identity with the Lord made her stand out. If not, who cared whether there was somebody in Nazareth? She identified with her Savior. Her connection to the Lord brought out the divine purpose for her life. When you are godly and you make God your priority, God entrusts kingdom agenda to you. When you fear God and you make God a priority in your life, in your home, He entrusts kingdom agenda to you. If your children will stand out from other children, it is because you fear God and you make God a priority in your home. If not, they would die ordinary. What made Hannah stand out was fear of God. What will make you stand out as a woman is your fear of God and making God your priority. Somebody said, I will make God my priority. So when you don't fear God as a woman, you lose significance. A woman that fears the Lord, beauty is vain. The Medicaid can fade. But a woman that fears God, she shall be praised. Number two, women that are used by God are women that make themselves available to God. You know, some women, they fear God, right? but they're not available to God. They fear God. But when it comes to that of God, they say, let me do my own first. So because God, they are not available to be used by God, they become only useful to themselves. But when you become available to God, you become useful to God, and you become indispensable to others. Somebody said, Pastor, how do you know that? Luke 1:38. Mary was willing to offer her womb that she had not even conceived the love of her life to be a womb for Jesus Christ. Do you know why other people are thinking, you know what engaged ladies do? They're thinking and dreaming of honeymoon, Hawaii. Mary had no Hawaii. Mary's honeymoon became visits to the OBGYN. And the time she was supposed to enjoy her time with her honey was marred with controversy of who is the father of the baby. But Mary was willing to take the heat so that the Savior could come out. That is why God said, blessed are thou amongst women. If God will bless you amongst other women, you must make yourself more useful than other women. Think about it. The lady that wiped Jesus' feet with her hair. How many people with their Peruvian hair will wipe somebody's feet? Think about it. Think about it. No. You know, we read these things. How many people will take their hair and wipe somebody's dirty? I'm not talking about hand. I'm not talking about face. I'm talking about feet. That I don't know where you went to. But until you go down, like John the Baptist said, I must decrease and he must increase. Your relevance does not go up. What I'm saying is, are you available to be used by the Lord? I'm not saying you are not holy. I'm not saying you are not holy. But is God's house, is God's agenda, is God's kingdom valuable to you? Will you close your eyes and see that things are not going well? And you say, well, you know, I'm just serving my own God, though. You know, this salvation is a personal thing. I'm talking about women. Mothers that is used by God. God is wanting to raise you, or you must be available to him. Mary said, be it, when the angel came, said, be it unto me according to your word. She was like, you know what? It's okay. Let people tell me, let people say all stuff about me, but I will be useful to the master. Someone said, Pastor, is that the only thing? Think about it. Mary was willing. How do you go to a party? A party that you are supposed to be a special guest. And Mary became the person that was serving wine. In John chapter 2, the Bible says that Mary was the one that found out that there was no wine. Women that are used by God open their eyes to see what is missing in God's glory. Women that are used by God. Women that are used by God are not careful about, I don't know whether I'm wearing too much today. No. It's not about too much. It's about, does God's glory match? Is God's house in order? Mary was the one that found out there was no wine. Mary was the one that set up her son for miracle. In fact, Jesus did not even know when he would come out. You are not hearing me. Jesus knew he's the son of God. After that first rebuke at the age of 12, Jesus did not show out until Mary said, come out. You are not hearing me. Am I speaking to somebody? So the next time, Jesus was still chilling, and Mary said, bro, your time is ready. And it was Mary that used the mouth to command the servants. Anything he tells you to do, go ahead and do it. Even the servants were afraid of Mary. All of them stand up. And Jesus said, fill the pot with water. So when you read at the end of that John chapter 2, where the Bible says, and from there the glory of God was now shown, it was Mary that caused Jesus to gain glory. Understanding that when you are useful to God, your acts produce glory to God. After this service, may your life bring glory to God. Am I speaking to somebody today? I said, after this service, may your life bring glory to God. Number three, women that are used by God, they are homemakers. They build their home and make sure that their home is conducive for God to dwell. You know, there are many homes that are good, beautiful, decorated with end home, at home, and Z gallery stuff. But that home, is not conducive for prayer. That home is not conducive for Bible study. And that home, no man of God can enter that home. You cannot dare have service in that home. They say, nobody should. You mean you wear your shoes into my carpet? Out. Are you bringing people from church? Don't even dare it. I don't have time to wash no dishes. Oh, yes. I'm telling you, women that God use. A true woman of God, your home should be open to people. I'm telling you, a true woman of God. If people don't come to your home, check your life. A true woman of God. If your home is not conducive to people, it's not conducive for God. Pastor said, how do you know? Sarah, Genesis 18. Let me read the scripture to you. I don't have time today, but you know, this is the, you may not believe it, this is the first Mother's Day message I'm preaching in 5 years. As a pastor, I've never preached on Mother's Day before. I've been waiting for today. Genesis 18. Are you ready? I don't want to take your time. Are you getting blessed this morning? If you're getting blessed, wave your hand, shout hallelujah. Genesis 18. Look at, the Bible says, verse 6, Abraham hurried into the tent. What did he say? To Sarah, quick, quick. He said, get the 3 seahs of finest flour and knead it. Abraham had emergency visitors. Some women, if you don't give them 2 weeks notice, nobody entered the house. But not understanding, those emergency visitors bring the biggest breakthrough. Somebody after today's service, may God bring an emergency visitor with testimony. Come on, if your amen is greater than your neighbor, double miracle will enter your house. Quick, quick. Sarah did not say, really, me, wake up from my afternoon sleep. They come. No, no, no. She built her home. Listen to her master. Quick. She was able to bring her formula, what they call it, her recipe. Knead the dough. Listen to me. God was one of the two, three people that came. I hope you know that. God ate Sarah's food. I thought it was spirit. When you are a good woman, God will eat your food. When you are a good woman, God will eat your food. I'm telling you, women that touch God, people, women that were used to God. Do you remember even when Samson was born? Manoah and the wife. You know, they say when you be hospitable as a woman, you will attract God. Some women, they don't greet nobody. They don't talk to nobody. Everybody, they love this. You will soon walk out of breakthrough. Things are hard for your husband because you have not understood the ability to be tolerant and hospitable. You don't understand what I'm saying yet. Quick, quick. They prepared the food. They served it to the Lord. The Lord, it was in the middle of the eating. All of a sudden, the Bible says, and God said, where is your wife, Sarah? And guess what? Go and read it. The Bible says, and Sarah was behind. So Sarah did not just drop the food and say, I'm going to hang out with the ladies. Bye. No. She was still around. She was around. So Sarah was very close to her husband, and Sarah supported her husband. Sarah was supporting caste. How do you know Sarah was a very beautiful woman? Even in her old age, Pharaoh still wanted to marry her. AB had nothing on Sarah. Someone hear what I'm saying? She was sitting there. Now let me show you, to tell you that Sarah was a different woman. Are you ready to see it? Are you all ready to see it? Now let me show you. Turn your Bible in the same scripture. The same scripture. Look at verse 12. You know the story. I'm not going to. I'm just picking some. Look at verse 12. So Sarah laughed at herself. Eh? As she thought. Everybody read that thing in quotation marks. Want to go? I'm not sure whether anybody saw what I saw there. She called her husband my Lord. Sarah never called her husband by name. John. Mario, this is the last time. In fact, the last time. Even in the New Testament, the scripture references that she called her husband Lord. The day you don't honor what is covering your head, you will lose the cap. Number four. Tell your neighbor, build your home. If your home is in disarray, there's a way. There's something you are not doing. And except God, your home is at peace and hospitable for God and conducive for God, there are some blessings that will not come to that house. You're not hearing me. There are some blessings. Some people are wonderful prayer warriors, but they are terrors in their home. Prayer warriors in church, prayer terror at home. Don't use your husband to do prayer point. Every man in this house, anything that they are doing, Father, fire them. Don't do that to your husband. Don't do that to your husband. Some people are sleeping in there. Anywhere the demons are gathered, Holy Ghost fire, pursue them. In your bedroom. In your bedroom. Who are you pursuing? Then you complain that the man has not touched you in 4 years. Number four. Are you ready for number four? Amen. Women that are used by God are intercessors. They are the generals of defense in their home. They are the defense minister. Women that are used by God are defense ministers. You are the defense minister of your home so that the devil doesn't have access to your home. If the devil wear pants, you wear double pants. Ladies, are you hearing what I'm saying? Yes, you are the intercessor. Hannah was the one that prayed the destiny of Samuel to pass. She prayed Samuel into existence. She prayed Samuel into prominence. If your husband is low, it's because you did not pray. What did another woman do that made her husband to go up that you cannot do? It is oil, baptizing with oil every day. What's that? It's true. Every great man of God is surrounded by a praying wife. I'm telling you, the moment you don't pray for your husband is open to attacks. You know you can fire anybody that's trying to tempt your husband. For what? Say his eyes always go. Tell the Lord, straighten his eyes. It's true. You don't believe that God can straighten eyes. God can open eyes. Instead of the man to be seen skirt, he will be seen things all over. I will be running all over. You just say, I cannot come. Elisha said, Lord, to Gehazi, open his eyes that he may what? Because some men have walked into mermaids. If only they knew that they were walking with their head on the ground. But the wife did not pray that his eyes may see. I'm saying some dangerous things. Whoever is under Adamayata, I feel the power of God. Go ahead and play. Anybody that is controlling your husband from afar, I release the fire of God to them now. Come on, come on, come on. All over this building. Anybody tempting your husband, anybody controlling your husband, I don't care who they are, by the fire of the Holy Ghost, I break their hold over your husband. I said, I break their hold over your husband. I said, I break their hold over your husband. If you believe it, shall fire. Hannah prayed her son up. Hear this. When you read 2 Kings chapter 4, the Bible was talking about a widow of a priest who the man died in poverty. I don't have time this morning. Died in poverty. Died in poverty. That they came to come and collect her two sons to pay a debt. Whereas it was oil. It was the woman that said, went to the man of God. Do you know that Elisha has been there? Because that man of God was the servant to Elisha. That man did not need to die. I'm telling you, maybe sickness killed him and he didn't have money to go to the hospital. Until the woman cried out, he said, they want to collect the two sons of your servant. He said, help me. Elisha said, what do you have in your house? He said, I have but a little oil. Ladies and gentlemen, that oil had been there since. But there was no intercessor to agitate it. Do you know when you pray, little oil becomes a refinery? Today, by the power of God, everywhere there's insufficiency in your house, as you pray, may it multiply. Come on, women. I said, as you pray, may it multiply. Everywhere your husband is struggling, as you call upon God, may God begin to activate financial resources for your home. If you believe it, let me hear your amen like thunder. I'm telling you, your husband, if he's lacking and you are the carrier of favor, it's because you are dormant. When you pray, the fire to release money will come out. How can you bring him good all his life that he's struggling? There's something fundamentally wrong with the picture. You know what is missing? Prayer. Pray, women. Godly women pray. Go and read in the scripture. Most of the prayers that Jesus answered, it was women that prayed it. Go read the Bible. God, you know, sister, God does not take the prayer of mothers as a joke. I need to stop. If I preach into the second service, God help me. Let me share one last one with you. Can I bless you with one more? Intercession. Matthew 20. In Matthew 20, I discovered as you get into verse 20, if you have a Bible like mine, you will hear the request of a mother. The mother of Zebedee's children, James and John, came one day. Told Jesus, Jesus, I have a request. Jesus said, tell me. I've never seen a woman that came to Jesus. Very few men came to Jesus. Somebody said, Pastor, all these women, only them fall under the anointing because men are too proud to be touched by, used by God. I'm telling you the truth. The mother said, Jesus, I have a request. Jesus said, what do you want? He said, I have one request. He said, in your kingdom, I want my two sons. One to be at your right hand, the other one to be at your left hand. Look at such audacity. Can you see that reckless boldness? Told Jesus, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, when you reach there, make sure John on the right, not James, so John on the right, Pastor John on the right, Kaba Sataya, James on the left. You know what Jesus said? Jesus said, this kind of thing you're asking is not in my hand to give. He said, can you drink the cup I will drink? You know what they said? They said they will drink it. carry the persecution. They say, we will carry it. Jesus said, okay. If I, for sure, you will carry it. Nevertheless, but it's not in my hand to give it to you. But let me prove a point to you, ladies and gentlemen. Are you ready? Are you ready for this point? Watch this out, people of God. Even though Jesus told her, that thing you are asking is not in my father to give. Apart from Peter, who did he take to Mount of Transfiguration? James. And what? Apart from Peter, which other people wrote books in the Bible? The first martyr was James. The last of them was John. When you provoke God with a request, he may not give you the answer right now, but that doesn't mean that heaven will not respect your prayer. Today, as you pray for your family, may heaven have respect for your prayer.
Thank you so much for watching this broadcast. We pray that this message ministered to your heart. If you are watching this message and you do not know Jesus Christ, we want to give you an opportunity to accept him as your Lord and Savior. Just say this simple prayer with us. Father, forgive me, for I have sinned against you. I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that you died and rose for my sins. I denounce and renounce any other God that I may have put before you. Jesus, save my life. If you said that simple prayer, we want to welcome you into the body of Christ. God is going to do some amazing things in your life. Join us at Bethel Covenant Assembly of God Sunday mornings at 9 a.m. and 11 a.m. at 6812 Bandera Road in San Antonio, Texas. And be sure to stay connected with us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and YouTube.